Dear students, welcome to today's session. In this session, we'll continue from the previous class in which we have seen a timer. A timer can be used to generate a different clock frequency or to count a number of events. Okay, if I want to use my timer, all the way it needs to be configured through TMOD register. Okay. It will configure our timer. There are two types of timers. That is a timer 0 and timer 1. Both the timer consists of 16-bit value with divided into TL and TH. TL 0, TH 0 for timer 0. TL 1, TH 1 for timer 1. Okay. Once this value will be loaded, your timer will be started. And when the timer will be getting started, it will keep on counting the value from the initial value what we have loaded. And when it reaches a maximum value, that is FFF, for a 16-bit, the maximum value is FFF. Okay. And all the way, your timer is connected with the TF bit. TF0 for timer 0, TF1 for timer 1. And we keep on monitor this bit. Okay. How we can monitor? By using an instruction. Okay. So this TF will be set to 1 when it is rolling back. When it is rolling back from maximum value to the initial count value, it will be set to 1. Okay. So we monitor this TFX bit through using JNB. Jump if TFX bit is not set, then it will be keep on looping it. Once it is set here, your loop will be broken. Okay, and we have to stop the timer. Once the timer is stopped, and we have to clear that the bit what it is set here, that is TFX bit has to be cleared, means it has to reset. And in the seventh step, we need to be again load with the TH and TL, and this process will be keep on loop it. Okay, this is what the mode 1 programming operation, how we are using our timer. Okay, let us see a simple program in which generation of a square wave of 50% duty cycle. When I say 50%, okay, your high and low will be of equal time interval. Okay, through port 1, that is 6th bit, that is P1.5 bit, means your duty cycle signal will be generated from port 1. And we are using a timer 0 to generate a different time delay operations. Look at this. All the statements are clear. Okay. I am using a timer 0. Okay. In mode 1. Okay. When I say timer 0, mode 1, all the way, it will be consists of 8 bits like this. T mode. Okay. In which mode you are using? That is timer 0, okay, in first mode. Timer 0, this will be indicated for timer 0. That is mode 1, okay, 1, 0. Okay, now C and T. Next bit will come here, C and T. Okay, we are using it for timer operation. That is 0. Gate, it is a software control, 0. All bits will be 0, 0, 0. Its hexa equivalent will be 0, 1, and it will be loaded into TMOD register. Since it indicates that your timer 0 is configured in which mode? Mode 1. Okay. Now you just compare from the previous slide. Okay, immediate next operation is you have to load with the TL and TH with some value. Okay, now this is what the step number 2. Okay, that is a TL naught will be loaded with F2, TH 0 will be loaded with FF, means my initial count value will be FF, F2. Okay, immediately, okay, I have to complement with the port P1.5. Assume that P1.5 is 0. If it is 0, okay, complement of that 1 means high will be, now it will be 0. Initially it will be low, okay, it will be set to high. Okay, means how long this interval will be high, okay, enabled high, okay, immediately we need to be called with the delay. This delay subroutine program, okay, as I told a statement, we can use a timer to generate a different clock frequency or a different time interval signal. So immediately I will call a timer by using delay subroutine program, okay, in which now this high will be there, immediately delay will be called. Okay, that is what, before going for the next slide, okay, here as we see there is a crystal frequency, means all the way your timer is connected to the crystal of your 8051 and the crystal frequency is fixed. Okay, assume that it is generating a 12 megahertz of frequency. Okay, the input to the timer will be 1/12 of that. 1/12 of means it is a 1 microsecond of time interval will be given to the timer. Okay, now timer will be connected with a clock frequency, that is a 1/12 of a crystal frequency. Okay, look at here. Okay, we can see this is a clock frequency, they are the 1/12 of crystal frequency. Now it is connected to the AND gate. It will be continuously generating 1 1 1 0 1 0 like this. Okay, now TR, timer, we need to set the timer. How? By using the instruction set B. Okay, now immediately when this here, okay, in the previous slide I loaded with FF here and F2. Once, okay, how the clock pulses are coming here, one, this will be keep on incrementing, F2, F3, FF, okay, F4, F5, FF. When it reaches a FF, okay, now before this counter, the TF will be 0. When it reaches a FF, maximum value, okay, we call it as a rollback, means it, when it is going back to the 0, 0, the TF will be set to 1. Okay, because once it reaches a maximum value, TF will be set to 1. That is an overflow plate, overflow bit. Okay, now again, it will be reload with the FF, that is reload with the previous count. What is the it is reaches a maximum value, FFF. Okay, what is the previous count? FF, F2. Okay, so assume that it is taken total, okay, F2, F3, 4, 5, like this, 13 clocks. And one more clock to reset to the original value. There's a total 14 clocks will be taken from the timer. Okay, this is ending and operation, what, how the timer will be set and reset. Okay, let us continue from the previous program. Okay, in between that, okay, I kept with a slide so that you can understand how the timer will be used. Okay, now this is given with a delay subroutine, okay, in which set B, okay, as I told from here, set B, you have to start the timer, we have to start the timer, that is set B, okay, TR0. Which timer we are using? Timer 0. It is started, means now this will be started, TR. Okay, in this TR there is an AND gate will be started, because the continuous clocks are coming to the one of the input to the AND gate. Now I have started my timer. Okay, once this timer is started, okay, this counter TH and TR will be started counting. Okay, look at here, in the fourth step what I given, delay subroutine will be called. In delay subroutine, timer 0 is started by set B, there is a TR0, fifth step. In the step 6, okay, now step 6, TR is 1, okay, your counter will be, there is a counter value will be keep on incrementing. Okay, how? Look at here, F3. Look at this, okay, F3, then F4, F5, 6, 7, 8, 9. A, B, C, D, E and F. Now maximum value, it reaches a maximum value. I hope you can see in the below diagram also, tf is 0, tf not equal to 0, tf not equal to 0. How long? Until it reaches a FFF. Okay, now it has to roll back to the initial value. What is that roll back here? This value. When it is rolling back, this tf will be set to 1. Okay, tf will be set to 1. Okay, that is what tf not equal to 1. Okay, when it is rolling back. Okay, at this point, okay, we are keep on monitor our tf not bit. Okay, means tf not bit will be 0. How long? For 13 clocks. Okay, and it will be keep on looping in the same instruction. Once this is set, tf not. Okay, the loop will be broken. When this loop will be broken, okay, the TR not, I have to stop my timer. The previously timer will be getting stopped, as we can see. Okay, in this here, stop the timer. Timer will be getting stopped by using what? Again, through using a software instructions. Okay, TR not, stop the timer. And the next is, now your TF is set to 1. We have to reset because this operation will be keep on looping. Okay, so that TF not initially it is set to 1 here, it will be reset to 0. Okay, that will be delay subroutine will be ends up here and it will be return. It will return to the previous program where it is left out. Okay, so since notice that to repeat the process, we must reload the TL and TH registers and start the process is repeated. Okay, I hope from this diagram it is very much clear. Okay, the counter value, you just observe the tf not will be 0. Okay, how long? Until it reaches FFF. Okay, now this is from the previous example itself only. How much is the timer? Okay, how much the time delay is generated? Okay, what is the time interval it will be generated by the subroutine? Let us will calculate here. Okay, now assume that your crystal frequency will be 11.0592 megahertz. Okay, as given in the example. Okay, now what is the statement here? 1/12 of this, 1/12 will be the input to the timer. Okay, as we divide, there is a 1/12 of this. What is the actual frequency? 11.0592 divided by 12. Okay, approximately it will come to 921.6 kilohertz of clock frequency. Means I will get here a clock of 921.6 kilohertz frequency. As a result, each clock has a period. Okay, if I want to calculate the period, we know that f is equal to 1 by t, that is t is equal to 1 by f. T is equal to 1 by f, that is the inversion, means I will get here approximately 1 microsecond of a time interval. 1 microsecond. Okay. That is input to the timer. Okay. We can see here. Okay. This will be 1 microsecond on. Okay. 1 microsecond time period. Okay. That's just on period will be 1 microsecond. Okay. That is. In other words, timer 0 counts up, okay, for every 1 microsecond. Look at this in the previous way. Okay, now how many clock pulses, okay, it is taken here to reach here, that is total, that is 13. Okay, that is what FF. Okay, the maximum value is FF. Okay, how much will be like, just it is subtract here, FFF minus FF2. So total how much here? 0D means 13 clock periods. For 13 clock period, okay, for 13 clock period, your timer will be, okay, keep on high. Means it will be high, okay, like this. It will be high for how many clock period? 13 clock periods. Means how much one clock period is not? One clock period is equivalent to 1.0585 microseconds. Okay. So like this, one extra time will be taken to rolling back. That is what? Okay, we add 1 to 13 because of the extra clock needed when it rolls from FF to 0. Okay, that is what? And it will be FF to 0 and raised to TF flag. That is, if there are the total 13 clocks are taken, one extra, there's a 14 clocks will be consumed. Okay, so that is how much time interval will be taken here. 14 into 1.085. Look at this one here. If I take here, okay, now, so what is the counter will be now? Total 13 plus 1, 14. Okay, for 14 clock interval of time, okay, when you see here, that is CPL 1.5 will be high. I hope you understood. This clock, what you can see, this will be high for how many cycle? 14 clocks. Okay, this will be high because CPL 1.5 high. Okay, I hope you understood here. Now when I say 14 clock, okay, one clock of the timer will be consumed approximately 1.085, I guess so. Multiply this. I hope you understood. Okay, this one. Okay, that is 1.085. That's approximately, it will come 15.19 microsecond, half of the pulse. Is the point clear? Okay, for the entire period, it will take, because high will be, okay, it is set to high. Okay, now what will be happening here? Look at this. When I say the program call delay, after the call delay, SJMP, again it will go to the here, in the sense what? Again it will loaded with the TL0 will be what? F2. TH0 will be what? FF. Complement of this. What is the value of P1.5? High. Complement of that is a 0. Now what the value will be now? This will be reset to 0. Again delay will be called. Again delay will be called here. When the delay is called, again with this timer will be started from where it will start again, FF2, because TH and TL are loaded with FF2. Again, how much clock period will be taken here? Again 14 clocks. There is a 14 clocks, it will be high, 14 clocks it will be low. Okay, one clock period is equal to how much you got here? 1.085 multiplied by 14. For how much time period it will be high? That is altogether 15.19 microsecond of time interval it will be high. And again equal square wave. Okay, for again 15.19 microsecond of a time interval it will be low. Okay, so altogether how much one clock frequency will get here? 30.38 microsecond of a time delay. I hope you understood this one. Okay, the how we are calculated here. Simple here. Okay, if it make it your clock high, that is a 1, will be remained high for how many clocks? For 14 clocks. Okay, 14 clocks, one clock frequency is 1.085. Multiply that. Means for the, you will get here 15.19 microsecond of time interval, it will be high. And 15.19 microsecond interval, it will be low. Altogether, I got an equal time period. There is a square wave. So, you will come up with like a 30.38 microsecond time interval. Okay. That is how we are calculated here. Okay. If the time period. Okay. Look at here. The same process what we are given, it will be calculated in this slide. Okay. Now, what is the maximum value for 16-bit? It is FFF. Okay. Now YYXX, YYXX are nothing but TH, TH0, TL0. TH0 is YY, TL0 will be XX. In previous class, in the previous example, we took with FF and F2. Okay, plus 1. I said one extra bit is required. Okay, in the previous way, okay, FFF minus FF2, total it will be 13. 13 plus 1, that is a 1 extra will be rolling back to the initial count. So 1 will be added. So you will be end up with like a hexa value of that hexa value into 1.085 microseconds. So where TYY, X are the initial count value. This is what you will get in hexa value. Okay. Or else, if you want to calculate in decimal, okay, as we know, FFF, 4FF, okay, F, okay, it is a hex, okay, its equivalent, okay, decimal will be 65536, okay. Now, 65536, it will be like a count value. Minus a number of clocks it is taken, that is 13 clocks, okay, NN, when I say NN here, nothing but, okay, that is FF2, okay, you just convert this FF2 in corresponding, okay, FF2 in the decimal value, that is NNN, okay, multiply by 1.085 microseconds. So all together we'll get here, okay, if I say approximately when I count with like FF, okay, when see in decimal conversion, okay, now 65536, okay, now what is the hexadecimal value we took here, FFF2, okay, its decimal equivalent will be 65522, minus of that 65522, okay, you'll end up with like approximately 14, okay, how much here, 1.085, okay. When we are converting in a decimal, you need not add with a 1 here. Okay, I hope it is clear here. Or if you are comfortable with the hex value, you can do this one. But there is a 1 extra bit will be added because 0 will be counted here. In decimal, it will be come up with the actual value. Okay, that is 1.085. I hope this point will be clear. Okay, with the conversion rate. Okay, this is what in the bottom line I have given here. Since once I have generated here, okay, of a square wave like this. Okay, sorry for this. Square wave like this. Like this. Okay, what is the time interval? Okay, for how many clocks it will be high? 14 clocks. For how many clocks it will be high? Low? 14 clocks. One clocking frequency is 1.085. This will be 1.085. Okay. Now, from where you got here 1.085? That is from the crystal. 14 clocks. Okay. Who has generated this 14 clocks? It is your timer. Okay. Now, for just a simple matter here. Now, I took here with the FF2. FF2. If I took it for FF0, that is FF0. Okay, now how many will be comes here? 16. Means 16 will be multiplied by 1.085. Will I get the same frequency? No, I may get a different frequency. Means the on period will be increased. Okay, that is what how we can able to get with the different clocking frequency. My frequency will be getting changed. Okay, now simple way, simple operation. If I say, if I got here, okay, if I got this one, will be something like my initial value will be loaded with 0005, some number. Okay, now what is the value here? It is a very quite large, I may get here, because 05, 06, 07, 08. FF means total how many clocks it will be on. Okay, you can imagine F approximately F A times. Okay, it will be come up with approximately, if I calculate from here, F A, if I get here, okay, it's decimal 65530 means 65530 into 1.085 microsecond into 1.085 microsecond. Okay, it is a quite high value you will come up. Okay, if I took here a value of like this, okay, that is 0005, okay, total how much time period will be on here, that will be, it will be on for 65530 times, it will be on, and 65530 times it will be off, means the total clocking frequency approximately you may get here, that is, if I say 71 millisecond of time interval, it is very, okay, like this your frequency will be changing. Okay, means you may get here 14 hertz clock frequency. Okay, this is how we can able to generate different clock frequency from the timer. Okay, I hope this will be the very 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 easy concept to understand. Okay, so that we can able to generate for a different clock frequencies. Okay, thank you.